We've told you before about bacteria on playgrounds, in bars, restaurants, and even public places.
But now we're taking our hidden camera swabbing test to a whole nother level, looking at the lemons and other fruit that you may use in your drinks. Tonight, WDSU News Channel 6 medical editor Dr. Corey Abair is on call to explain the risk to your health.
Can I take your order?
Yeah, can I get a sweet tea, the dollar one, with the lemon?
Did you know that the lemon in your tea may be a haven for bacteria? We wanted to find out if those citrusy garnishes could really make you sick, so we enlisted the help of Dr. Lisa Morisi at Tulane Medical Center.
For this investigation, we're going to send you guys out into the field with a sterile culture tube, and so just collect your specimen, place it in the sterile culture tube, cap it, and then label it.
Good to go, germ busters. Go get them.
Armed with the tools of the trade, Dr. Maurice's instructions, and a hidden camera, we went to five different places in New Orleans, two fast food restaurants, two bars, and a coffee shop. We took lemons and limes for samples and handed them off to Dr. Maurice for testing.
I would expect to find more bacteria on the rind, which is not the acidic part, and it's protected from that thick peel, and then obviously that's where the hands are usually touching the surface of the lemon, so I would expect to find more on the rind than on the flesh, but we'll see.
48 hours later, the test results were in, and they were somewhat surprising, especially as to where most of the bacteria turned up.
And so you can see on this side of the plate is the flesh of the lemon that was cultured, and on this side of the plate is the rind that was cultured, and you can see that there are many more bacteria growing on the flesh of the lemon. So the coffee shops and the bars actually had more bacteria on their lemons and limes that were cultured than the restaurants.
Dr. Maurice says one of the samples revealed what's called lactose fermenting bacteria, bacteria that lives in the gut of all healthy individuals.
And perhaps someone, went to the restroom and did not wash their hands properly before preparing the food.
Not good. But Dr. Maurice says what she found here is really only a concern if you have a weakened immune system.
So I think if you enjoy a lemon on your iced tea, it's safe to go ahead and enjoy a lemon in your tea.
Wow. So again, Dr. Abair, the bottom line is, what amount of danger are we in with these fruits?
In actuality, this test showed that New Orleanians are very clean with this, with our lemons and limes and everything else we put in our drinks. However, it's still something that you have to watch out for because this is just an isolated test. We could actually test a whole bunch and then some of them could actually come back with really bad bacteria.
Is there anything that people can do to make sure that everything, limes, lemons are clean?
I would make sure when you go to a restaurant and you're sitting down there, get an extra glass of water and wash those lemons in the water before you put it in the water that you're going to drink. And that will decrease the bacteria concentration, which will tell you if you put it in there at that point, should be a little bit better than if you didn't wash it at all.
Okay, good deal. Thank you for it very much.
Hey, I'm proud of us.
Yeah, good deal. Good deal. You can also bring your own squeezed bottle of lemon juice.
There you go.
An idea.
Lemons from home.